Well, something just popped up then.
You sure you want to start? Yeah, I do.
I totally do.
You can, oh, you can have that one, Campbell. Because otherwise I'll just give it to Zero.
Give what to Zero?
Yeah, popped up a code. That you could tweet out.
Oh. Okay, I'll have to get to that.
Oh, so wait, I can pick my character off of your screen. Perfect.
Is that going to be a good angle for you?
Sure.
Oh, let's go with
on.
That.
Hold on, this person's pretty alright. Let's see.
I don't see it live right now.
Okay. What do you think, Allison? The skeleton thing or the purple haired one? I think I'm going with the purple haired one.
I like the purple haired one.
I had to put an anime girl in there once.
It's like a rule, really.
It seemed right. Maybe not right. Appropriate? Wait, no, not appropriate either. Necessary. There we go.
Yeah, that is the word.
Okay.
We're going to get trashed. Oh, it's loot, too. Okay.
Sorry, Lim, I'm going to get past you here. What's up, everybody? We're live.
Okay, I don't know what color
we are.
I am.
Live. Welcome to the couch. Oh, and the rounds have started already. Whoa. We're playing Sombrero today. Welcome.
Oh, you bugger.
We also have special guest, Mr. Nick Rabalik. How are you doing, sir?
Pretty good. How are you guys doing this fine Monday
evening?
Very
happy to be playing this game with you on this day.
Yeah? Did you all enjoy your April Fools's?
Yeah.
Oh, very much so.
We did. Too crazy.
Yeah, no, gags don't go too crazy over here.
Oh,
now that Garrett's not really.
We all just died there, eh?
We had this one friend that was just really brutal. What did he do? He froze Robin's keys once in like a big ball of ice.
Well, that's awesome.
He layered it over like 3 or 4 times, I think. And he just, because we all worked in a kitchen together, he just kept it in the freezer over there.
Oh, that's so good. That's,
God, I'm getting lost. I'm getting lost and confused. No, he spawned on something.
I don't know. I watched the latest Rick and Morty episode, so that was like
which was
a wonderful
fantastic.
April Fool's for
cool.
me.
Good stuff. I haven't seen it yet. I'm behind. And I'm an episode behind on Samurai Jack, too, so don't.
Well, I think we're a few episodes behind. Yeah. We've at least seen the first two, nice. But like we're trying to keep current with it. There's just too much TV, man.
Yeah. I'm glad we're back in good adult cartoon season, though.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
amen.
Oh, God damn it.
Fucking finally, man. After that shitty Powerpuff Girls reboot, I had serious worries about Samurai Jack, but it all ended well.
Oh, Lance.
Oh, good.
Is that done already? Samurai Jack
is what
done
already?
Samurai Jack.
No, they have a few more. I'm not sure how many episodes they're doing. But I'll keep watching them if they keep making them.
Yeah, man, absolutely. For what we saw, it was good,
nice,
right?
Shot.
Yeah,
we
man.
We even got
I
a couple of our friends into it, like those who haven't
really,
seen
really
the show
good.
Before.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, the original series was a big inspiration for the look of all the loading screens and backgrounds in Sombrero.
Okay.
Oh, really?
I totally see that.
Yeah.
That's awesome, man.
Like, especially, what was the last one that I made? Like, the church one? Like, the one that's shaped like a skull church thing? It's
okay,
the last
okay.
stage on the list. I'm having trouble remembering what it's called, and I made it. The Monasterio de los Muertos. The background in that one is, like, very Samurai Jack.
Oh, nice.
Like, that one may be more so than some of the others.
Okay.
Yeah,
I can totally
yeah
see
just
it.
Like the weird color contrast and the.
You know. Oh man!
Oh, we all die. That's funny. Oh, oh.
So what drew the inspiration to like come up with the concept of this game? Like you say,
oh,
Samurai
which,
Jack
which,
sort
which
of
part, like the. Oh yeah,
just,
Samurai
overall,
Jack.
What made you want to do okay. this party game?
Well, I didn't. And so, I didn't start out making a party game. I started making a, and this will explain some of the controls too, and why the triggers or the shoulders are jump. I started out just doing an overhead twin stick shooter.
Okay.
Kind of like a Smash TV or Total Carnage or Robotron, one of those kind of games.
Nice.
And I built out like a stage, like this, did the art and like made a little mini boss and all that kind of stuff, and got it to the point where it was like, it was decently polished. And I said, this sucked. Like, this is boring. Like, this is just like, this is not, there's nothing super exciting about this. Everyone's played this game before. Like, if they've ever played Ikari Warriors or anything like that, I was like, I need to do something else, but I don't want to start over. And Sombrero was born.
Oh, no.
And yeah, I mean, it was pixel art and all that stuff, all that indie stuff we're supposed to do.
Yeah.
And so Sombrero ended up being like a complete reaction to that. It's like, I'm not doing pixel art. I'm going to do everything high res, like illustrations, which ended up being a bitch to get done because there's so much to do. But I think it was still the right decision. And yeah, then it ended up just kind of turning into a party game from there, without any real intention to turn it into a party game initially.
Okay.
And yeah, I like spaghetti westerns, so the theme kind of started there, and then got a little weirder when I started adding in alien characters and UFOs in the background of the stages.
Did it always
sci-fi too. So.
Yeah, man. Did it always start as spaghetti western? Was that always like sort of the foundation you wanted to
build on? When I started on like this version of it, after I decided that doing the twin stick shooter was a terrible idea. Yeah, it started out as spaghetti western, like right from the beginning. Just because I just like it. Like, I probably own every spaghetti western made. So, it's just even the really bad ones. That is, I get a kick out of it. And I grew up watching them with my grandfather, so it was like a bonding thing.
Oh, okay.
God, man, I just can't keep
My grandfather's a huge fan of Bonanza. Really likes that.
Yeah, yeah. It was one of those kind of things. Yeah. And then my grandfather was Italian, so of course he liked the Italian westerns. What do you guys want to do? Do you want to do a rematch after? Wait, how did
Who
I
won
that
one?
Oh. I wasn't even trying to win.
Oh, you bugger.
Yeah, I've been having a conversation here with Nick.
See, that's why I was talking so much. If when I talk, I get distracted.
Oh,
you hear that, Humphrey?
Talk's coming out.
Yeah, I didn't. Wait, hold on. I didn't even mean for that to be shit talking.
I'm just really I put in some work. I went quiet. I was just like, no, I gotta fucking do some shit. I couldn't do it.
Okay, well.
Bad start. Lance got a good jump on me. Let's get another one going.
Okay. So we'll do a new match. Yeah.
What are we doing here? How do I do this?
If you go to main menu. Then from there we can alter the game settings.
I'm not. That's Lance.
Oh, that's me. Sorry.
Welcome, Pure Filler, who's in the chat right now.
Oh, that's Matt Scott. Ended.
Oh, okay.
Hi, Scott.
Hey, Scott.
Hello, Scott.
Couch play. What would you guys like to play next?
Let's go deathmatch. Let's throw down.
Deathmatch. All right, Humphrey.
Go to the far right. Let's go to that skull level he was talking about. Yeah. Let's get some Sam Jack in this.
What am I doing? Sombrero online here?
You are online, right? We are waiting for players. Okay, there should be a server to connect to there.
No open matches.
I don't know if that was the
go to go to online.
There we go. Create match.
There you go. Create.
My bad.
Death match.
That's fine. Do you have a choice of game type there, Nick?
I guess you guys want to do death match? I'm down.
I'm killing.
I've played all of them, so it's totally
Which
fun.
Which one would you say is your favorite?
I'm a big fan of Loot. That was the first one I did. Oh. And it's probably the most complicated one.
I don't think I played that one with you guys.
Loot?
Yeah.
That's the one we just did, too.
Oh, okay. Well,
yeah, that collecting.
Shows yeah, that one's... Each other. Yeah, that one's... You gotta kind of try and balance running around and grabbing money and the campfires and...
Wait,
not getting shot.
What do the campfires do?
What campfires?
Ha ha ha! See? Someone didn't read the instructions.
I didn't.
No! I'm sorry, what? A true man doesn't read instructions.
But that's why.
That's not
why
true.
That's why
true
men lose.
Yeah.
So each campfire you capture, you stand in front of the campfire for like half a second or a quarter of a second. I forget what it is. It'll turn your player color and you know you've captured it. And so each campfire you get acts as a score multiplier for the bags of money. So it makes every bag of money worth more, which is probably why I won.
I get what. Yeah, I get it now. I figured out what happened. I can tell you how I'll play that next time.
So I got to find everybody's place in here. Gingy Beardy is Lance, and Couchikins is Humphrey.
Oh, nice shot.
Oh,
nice.
So Nick, are you just kind of like,
oh fuck,
are you working on anything new, or is this still like development going on with this game, or what's happening right now?
Both of those things. So okay. I have another stage I want to add, a couple more characters, couple more power-ups. I'm reworking some of the multiplayer work, so you can switch your region right from the match screen, which I think will save a lot of time and headaches. And you'll also be able to do friends only matches, and then, you know, if one of your friends has started a match, that match will show up in a different color, so you know it's one of your friends, that kind of stuff, like little I would call them quality of life tweaks to the multiplayer stuff. And right now, and I'm not sure if I want to do it yet, but I think I should. Right now, if someone customizes a match, you know, like changes the rounds or changes the weapon that you start with, that kind of stuff, that doesn't really show up on the match screen. And so I want to rework the match screen a little bit so that does show up there, like how many rounds it is, how long the rounds are,
if anything's jump speed.
Yeah.
Hold the trigger down longer.
No way.
So jump higher,
What's your new project going on? Are you at liberty to talk about that?
Don't do it. Don't
I can't talk. Really. Okay. I can't really say. That's it's a platformer. Enough. It's more of a. I can tell you that it's a platformer. It's a action platformer.
Sweet. Okay. Sounds great. I'm looking for.
God damn it!
I think that's as broad as a category as I can think of.
It's all good, man.
I haven't actually decided on what the theme's going to be. I tend to start with the gameplay first and then figure what it's going to be later.
Nice. Nice.
That feels... Gameplay first feels like a good...
Oh, nice.
Way to go about it.
Upplay Johnny.
Absolutely. Cannot agree more. Are you excited for Yooka-Laylee coming out here pretty soon? My mind instantly went to that as soon as you said platformer.
Wait, is that me? Am I Couchikins?
Yeah,
okay,
you're Couchikins.
Yeah.
Congrats, sweet. Humphrey, on round two there.
Yooka-Laylee. I played a little bit of that at GDC. It feels very... I mean, it's Banjo-Kazooie.
Yeah, I was going to say.
It's so blatantly Banjo-Kazooie that, you know, there's way back in the day... you know, companies are suing each other for stealing, like, gameplay elements, that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And those lawsuits always got shut down. It's like, oh, you can't copyright an idea like that. But Yooka-Laylee is so obviously Banjo-Kazooie that it almost feels like Microsoft would have a really strong case against them. Because it's so exactly what you want from a Banjo-Kazooie game. Like, not nuts and bolts. So like an actual Banjo-Kazooie game?
Yeah, but the fact that they have something like Nuts and Bolts to exist, does that not, like, provide a bit of, like, gray area for, like...
Nuts and Bolts would have been awesome if all of those features were included inside a Banjo-Kazooie game, I think, instead of just a game that was branded Banjo-Kazooie and it was a weird custom cart thing.
Yeah.
I think they just got forced to... release it. It never felt done. It never felt done to me as a game. It felt like half a game. I mean, what was there was fun, but it wasn't. It was a Banjo-Kazooie. So if you like Banjo-Kazooie, buy Yooka-Laylee.
Absolutely.
Because that's exactly what it is.
Yeah, I'm waiting for it. I'm so patiently waiting for it. You got a lot of. Well, I got a lot of fun out of the toy box.
That's it.
That was pretty much it.
Yeah.
Good job. Who just won?
Lance took it.
Okay. It says Gingy on your screen, but it says Couchikins on his screen.
Yeah.
Weird. Couchikin wins.
Yeah, you definitely won.
Huh.
You're Couchikin.
Well, nicely done, sir.
Beard. Oh, well, either way, good game.
Nick says he got Gingy, so I think through majority rules. Lance, congrats, sir. No, back out. You went back to couch play. You don't have to continue to leave the game. We could just stay in the same match, right?
Can you do that?
I think
no,
so.
Oh, no, well, it's
yeah,
a
you can,
rematch,
you can,
right?
You can do a rematch, yeah.
Gotcha.
Scott here says that Nuts and Bolts was great, and you're a monster.
Scott's a filthy liar. I mean, but at the same time, that is his job, though. He is a PR guy, so.
Well,
yeah. He knows I'm joking. I love him.
Can I bug you like for another beer, sir?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, who do I want to be this time? I was, no, you know what? I think I got to stick with my gut on this one. Oh, wow, that skeleton guy's way different. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with the anime girl.
So, anything else you'll look forward to this year, game wise?
Game wise?
Yeah, man.
No, honestly, I don't even know really what's coming out.
All I care about is Destiny 2. Got to make it to that one.
Yeah, I never played the first one.
Oh, I wish I could say the same thing.
Yeah. See, that's the reaction I got from people who did play it. I just didn't want to say that in case you actually liked it.
So, no, I played a lot actually. I love that game.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I feel like the people I know they said the same thing. They played it a lot and I mean it's been out for a while now. They said they played it a lot and they're still not sure if they like it.
Oh, he has the monkey! Oh no!
Don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I just realized we're playing Pantheon.
Yeah, <it's just> like, this is how he beats us all the time in this. Because we just forget that we're doing something. I can't get him.
Make that circle more obvious in the next update.
Oh, I hit him! What a snipe!
I got him.
It's okay. Change the question a bit. Are you playing anything these days?
Yes.
Oh, nice shot.
I'm playing a lot of old games.
Yeah,
I went back to Quake 1, which is still fucking awesome, which surprised me. I didn't think it was gonna be, and I had to get used to the skating around, the way it moves compared to more modern stuff. But after that, it was like this game's awesome still. Putting a new skin on top of it with some mods helped a lot.
I think I have the monkey, but it's not firing
off.
That's
great. Why is the monkey not?
Can't say
oh, no.
I spawned on top of the monkey, and it instantly just made
me
fire.
Yeah, we fought at the monkey. The monkey exploded. Now we have no monkey.
No, the monkey's on me.
No, you're not getting
he's got the ring around
I have the ring
around
the
monkey, right?
I have the monkey, but I'm firing regular bullets.
But you're also not getting time. Like, there
yes,
it is. There's the monkey.
I have 54.2.
Monkey!
Oh, on mine you don't. Oh, that's weird. That's so weird.
Whoa. Yeah, I think you just found a glitch. That is a that's killing.
Yeah, mine says 2346 and the yours wasn't going up.
I spawned just right on it and then I'm like firing regular bullets.
So what happened was is you spawned right on top of the idol?
Yeah.
Okay, then, so that's the issue.
Was it no what I spawned on top of the idol, you came to fight it and then we blew each other up on it and then it never just spawned back and you had it.
Oh, gotcha.
That's
gotcha.
What happened. Well I'll go back. It's in the video. We'll figure it out. But oh
that'll be myself. That'll be a fun bug to find. Sounds like, yeah. So. This happened, and this happened. Oh, okay. Great. Awesome. I'll fix it in the next week or so.
Oh, you bugger.
That's documented now. That's out there. People are going to hold you
to
that.
That's fine. That's completely fine with me. That's why I say these things out loud to people that can hear them, so that I can get held to them. No, that's fine. Yeah, so Quake, and I finally played through Stalker.
Okay.
Which I have to say, I was surprised at how much I enjoyed it. And a lot of New Doom. I've played so much New Doom that it's embarrassing as an adult. I've spent so much time playing New Doom.
No, Doom is a riot, man. That new game they did, it's amazing. I'm lost for words right now. Carson and I were both big fans of that game.
I heard it did really well. Yeah, I didn't play it yet.
Oh, I hope so. No, it's not old Doom, but it's how I remember old Doom being. And I think that's exactly what I wanted out of Doom.
Yeah.
I'm so glad they canceled the other version they were doing. That version that just seemed like a little. It seemed very Call of Duty, the other one they were working on before they canned it. Nice. And yeah, New Doom, so good.
Whatever they did, best decision they ever made.
It was. It's just so good.
To me, I think it fulfills the. I don't know if you've got this, but like I was a huge fan of Halo 2 back in the day.
Of course.
And the multiplayer to me, and I think it's just because of how the players look, but the pacing of it and all that kind of stuff, you still get energy shields technically.
Oh, nice.
You know, all of those elements are there, and I think it just kind of fills that void that I haven't really seen. I guess I should have said Halo 3. Since Halo 3, I haven't really seen that kind of satisfaction from a Halo game, and Doom really does that for me.
Yeah, I haven't played the multiplayer at all.
Really?
I mean, I'm just talking about single player. Well, to me, Doom is a single player game.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know, well, it needs to have that campaign. But I should try the online play. Yeah.
Oh, it's so fun, man. There's so many collectibles too. Like you get different taunts and sections to your suit, of course. Like that part of it is hilarious.
Is it just the you spawned with it thing? Is that what's happening?
Yeah, like it happened again where I spawned with it.
They got some cool game types to go with it too. But anyways, that's enough of Doom. Just wanted to put that out there. I love that game.
I don't have time.
What about you guys? What have you guys been playing?
Lately, I think I'm the oddball of the bunch here. I'm playing Ark Survival and Osiris Mugan, which is basically what No Man's Sky should have been. I got one that's like
those
on the
poor
ground,
guys.
Primitive with dinosaurs, and then I've got another one where I'm doing interstellar space. And I mean, it's only on one planet right now. It's very early access, but I adore it. There's something that's really great about it.
Visually,
it's just beautiful.
Have you tried Elite at all? Because I found that to be a lot
Elite
of fun.
Dangerous?
Yeah.
I have dabbled, but like I don't know. How
much bathroom, Allison? Take over.
To be honest, it's been a little while since I've dived into that game, so that's the one where
it's kind of time-consuming, really. But it's fun when you get to do things. Yeah. It's fun.
Mm-hmm.
Being a space trucker is fun.
Ooh, what is it? Endless Space has kind of got my curiosity a little bit.
Did you guys want to read?
I haven't tried that
one
yet.
That one, they have like an alien race that rarely shows up, and their space.
I'll hit rematch. Oh, no, too late.
Damn it. And apparently, their model of space is so accurate that they actually, of that new solar system of like the 8 planets that NASA announced that they had discovered and shit like that, that actually exists in their solar system. So they've just kind of tweaked it to make it identical to the real world counterpart, but like, that people just kind of discovered that it was there within the same. Quadrant or what have you. I don't know what goes into actually tracking that shit down, but yeah.
Science.
I do like my space games. We were talking earlier about Alien Isolation. I feel we haven't played enough of that for Spooky Couch. We didn't even get to a monster, guys.
To a monster?
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
We played it for Spooky Couch almost like, I think it's 2 years at this point, and we got so far into it that I think the monster was basically right behind a door. we played it for so long, everybody was just like, okay. Well, I mean, we got spooked. I think we got what we needed, so.
There's some good moments with Alien.
Mm-hmm.
In Alien Isolation, for sure. There's some good real creepy moments.
Yeah.
Which I like. I like creepy better than jump scares, I think.
Yeah. The immersion, right? The just...
Yeah. I want my skin to crawl. Like, that's scarier to me than, like, someone does something jumping in front of me and trying to spook me that way.
Yeah.
To me, I just view that as, like, a continual reaction, you know? It's like, if something...
Yeah,
something
yeah.
Something's always just popping up, you're just naturally going to be like, oh, holy shit.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Right, exactly. And it kind of wears me out. It just makes me feel exhausted when I see stuff like that.
Which one's this?
Yeah.
I don't get scared, I just get frustrated.
I'm actually not sure. Oh, Deathmatch.
Yes, Deathmatch. And I thought, Resident Evil 7 has some good moments like that, too, that are just creepy.
Mm-hmm.
And their jump scare moments are much better, I think, than a lot of the other YouTube Scream at Me games.
Yeah.
Yes.
No, there's a lot of good things coming with Resident Evil. I think we're going to play that here pretty soon.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Yeah. That was...
Okay. I'm doing
I wasn't sure about that one, because I'm not really a fan of those first-person scary games generally, but I just heard too many people saying, no, you have to check this out. This is like Texas Chainsaw Massacre. It's like a sold.
That's a great way of putting it. Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah. Just for just the first 5 minutes of the game, it's just like, oh, this is good. I like this already.
Yeah.
No punches pulled. I don't see that very often.
Oh, big damn, budget. Right off the hop.
Yeah, that was a good shot. You guys are getting better at it. I can already see you getting better.
Well, we have two very dedicated players on this side.
There you go.
Yeah, man.
I just, like I said, I love these games, man. I always have fun playing these.
It's okay, move it down the line. Humphrey, what are you playing these days?
For me, man, I'm trying out that new Battlegrounds game. I really like that one.
What's the user's name for it? Like,
Player Unknown.
Player Unknown.
Yeah, Player Unknown's Battleground. It's, yeah. It's pretty. I never played H1Z1 or any of those other games, so I didn't have any of those other ones to kind of get it out of my system.
But it's based on a game mode from those games, right?
Yeah, it's the same kind of concept. And H1Z1. Yeah. Land somewhere, pick shit up, try not to die. Mm-hmm. Other than that, I just play Destiny.
Lance has this one game he really wants us to play, but we never seem to have a PlayStation 3 around the house to pop it in.
Oh, yeah. I really want to play it, man. It seems good.
What's it called again?
Dragon's Crown.
Okay.
Yeah.
Woot woot. That's one for me.
Oh, nice.
Started getting the power snipes.
Speaking on behalf of Carson, Minecraft's been happening in here. Lot lately. Yeah. That and Borderlands 2. He seems to be going back to Borderlands 2.
I always go back to Borderlands 2. I feel like I'm a Gearbox whore for it. Just like always find myself playing it one day. Like, and I'm just always like, why? Why am I doing this? It's a great game. I get that.
But oh, nice.
He's done it so much.
It's old, and I've played this campaign like 100 times.
I think Carson was actually looking to stream it.
Oh, I'm alive! Oh my god! The orange is an interesting color to see come in.
How do you mean? Is it blending in too much?
No. I just.
You gotta be worried now.
I notice like the blue one and the yellow one extremely, and then it's just the orange one is on the color scheme not as bright as those two.
Yeah. On this stage especially. Yeah.
Oh man, always those
spikes are like the bane of your existence.
They right are. Now. I just keep dying to them.
Get out of here.
Oh no!
Oh my god! Did you forget that there's destructible? Structures?
No.
Maybe.
Oh, I got both of you.
That's all I see Nick doing is putting holes in the boardwalks.
I'm just doing that and letting you guys kill yourself. Because it doesn't increase my kill count, but it takes yours down. So, that's my method.
After so long, Nick has finally panned out the best strategy.
I mean, maybe not death badge.
Yeah.
I'm rocking around with 8 kills.
Sorry, he's also not trying. No Destiny.
Oh no! Oh. Every time.
Oh, can I get 10 kills before the match ends? Oh, I'm not gonna be able to do it. Oh, so close.
See, wait. Now, see, nice on mine job, it says Humphrey. 8 takedowns. On him, it says 9 takedowns. What's
9 kills. His says kills.
Oh.
Yours says takedowns. You must get a different stat.
Yeah, oh, that's something else I'm going to change, and you can hold me to this, too. I want to put all on one screen, on the last screen, what everyone's score count was for all the game modes.
Oh, jeez.
I think that would be good. So everyone can see how they did, instead of how well just the winner did.
That but feels I mean, better. I'm not opposed to looking good.
Well, it'll still be the bigger font, the winner. And everyone
get
else
out of here, Lance. God damn it.
I'm yellow. I'm just barely trying to survive.
The spawns are what really make and break like each level, to be honest. Like sometimes you just end up in a bad spot.
So
oh, nice shot.
What length of development time would you say it's taken to get this game to the state it's at?
It's hard to say. The first maybe a year and 8 months that I worked on it. I was doing it part-time while working full-time. And so it would be, there would be time periods during that where for 2 months I was just, you know, too exhausted to work on it, and I wouldn't touch it. And then the last year was more or less full time on it, because I was just doing some freelance stuff on the side, and the game was like the main project to get it finished and get it out the door. So probably if I put all the time together, probably somewhere like maybe a little over 2 years, but spread out over probably a little over 3 years.
Oh wow.
Okay.
That's yeah, crazy. It took a long time. Don't make a game and do everything yourself. That was a terrible idea.
But the payoff, man. The payoff has got a
the payoff.
Sum, right?
I'll let you know when I get that.
Come on.
I mean, it was fun to work on, and it was nice to get it out the door. You know, I always wanted to make a game. Even in high school, I interned at a local game company, and I ended up going a different career path because working in game development pays shit. So I went and did something else instead. And it's true. I mean, and it's all relative too. I mean, it gets paid decently once you get to a certain point in your career, like everything else. That's an office job, but compared to the same point in the career in like other industries where you're doing the same kind of stuff, the pay is really low for the amount of work that you have to do. Like, I don't think people understand that the work that goes into a big AAA budget game is a lot of the time more work than goes into doing, you know, the special effects for an Avengers movie. You know, it's like you're not just animating that stuff. You need to make all that stuff animated and interactive and look movie quality at this point.
Mm-hmm. Those are usually like teams of like 50 people.
Oh, I mean, 150 people.
Yeah.
You know, you should see the credit list on something like Grand Theft Auto 5. I mean, it's not just 150 people; it's hundreds of people working over years and years and years.
With almost an unlimited budget on it, too.
Well, that's true. Maybe that's a bad example because Grand Theft Auto is a little bit different. But yeah, there are games that you see that come out that you think have a big budget, and then content gets cut, or there's weird bugs in Mass Effect Andromeda, right?
Yeah.
The entire game seems to be made of bugs.
Yeah. That was really.
And it's a shame because it makes everyone's work look bad, right? Mm. I think who did I see talking about it? Ken Levine, you know, BioShock guy, or BioShock like designer. So, okay. You know, it's probably not even the animator's fault that this stuff looks like shit. There's something wrong with the actual animation system, you know, in the game engine and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And you can see it because when it works right, like, it looks good. I mean, it doesn't look as good as it should for a Mass Effect game with the kind of budget they had, but like it looks better than it does most of the game. But there's all these weird glitches and stuff.
Yeah.
But gameplay-wise, it's a Mass Effect game. If you like Mass Effect games, you'll like that. And I don't like Mass Effect games. So, to me, the gameplay is not great. So it's one of those things where, you know, I like sci-fi. I like story-based sci-fi a lot. Story-based sci-fi RPG should be right up my alley. But I will not sit there for hours and scan fucking planets. I just absolutely refuse to do that. And then when I'm not doing that, I have terrible dialogue or somewhat mediocre shooter mechanics.
I thought the combat was probably the redeeming quality, really.
Out of Andromeda, probably the best part. Yeah, cause in the previous games, I guess I should say it wasn't the best combat.
But really. Wasn't it the situation I heard it was is that the entire team that like initially made the game left, and it was the multiplayer team that stuck around, which is.
I hadn't heard it was the multiplayer team yet. That's interesting.
Because if it was the multiplayer team, that would explain why it's evolved and it feels like the best part of that game. Whereas the story kind of, or just the whole concept of the game didn't really seem like it was the old ones, you know?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's different writers, yeah, it's different creative directors, different art director. I don't know what they were thinking with that dialogue, though. I mean, it's like seventh grade fan fiction. It's just... It's a shame again because it's a great idea. What a great way to restart such a popular series that really had a definitive end. It's like if you have to, you know, if you have an IP that's a cash cow, fine, you're going to make sequels. And the initial idea of it, it's like, oh, we're in a new galaxy, all this stuff, you know, been in hibernation, separate from everything else. It's like, this is awesome. This is like Star Trek Voyager territory. Yeah. Like, sign me up. And then you see how it was executed, and it's just kind of like, what were you thinking? Like, how did this even get through copy editing? Like the dialogue, it's, you know, it wasn't great. I can't think of the right word for it, because mediocre doesn't sound mean enough for what I really think about it. But I don't want to say what I really think about it either, because that's way too mean. I need to find something in between. It's not what it could be.
And it's unfortunate too, because like I just played through Horizon before Andromeda came out, and I thought Horizon did a fantastic job at, for once in my life, seeing a realistic human character not looking weird all the time. I mean, they're still weird.
Are you talking about, is this Horizon Zero Dawn?
Yeah.
Random name game. That game looks beautiful.
It was phenomenal.
It's just, I can't believe how good that game looks. I haven't actually really played it yet.
Yeah, like there was a lot. I got attached to characters and stuff. Like I had love interests there was guys I even in that game. I was just like, wow, that guy's kind of cool. I like running into that character. And you know, it's like, it was kind of an interesting thing though. You got attached to a lot of people. Like the storyline was really cool and kind of sad. And you know, yeah, I thought it was a great game and it was beautiful.
That's cool.
And that was one thing. The animation, although like I think all animation when it looks too realistic starts to do that. It starts to look too realistic. And
oh, you hit that. That uncanny valley.
Yeah. And I thought it hung out just outside of that barrier perfectly. Like, it was realistic enough that I was like, wow, that was really cool, but it wasn't too realistic that it made it look creepy.
All right, I'll check it out. Is that console only?
I think it's only PS4.
That's a fact.
Zero Horizon Dawn. Horizon Zero Dawn.
Horizon Zero Dawn, as far as I know, is a PS4 exclusive.
Alright, so I'll probably never play it.
Did you play the Legend of Zelda game?
No. I refuse to buy a console just for a single game.
Yeah, you're right.
I've been down that path with Nintendo before.
I said that same thing, man. I wanted the Switch, and we were going to get it, and then it kind of sold out really fast. I was like, cool, but there wasn't much going for it, so I'm not terrified.
But Nintendo's consoles always sell out really fast, because they purposely short all of their distributors.
Yeah, and that generates demand.
It generates the buzz. Hey, it's sold out. It's like, yeah, that's because you had it at Best Buy in Times Square, and you only had 10 Switches. That's why it's sold out. Yeah.
I would assume, though, that Horizon will come out for Steam eventually.
I think it will.
It seems like the kind of game that would. It's too good
to just stay on one console.
They might rip it off of Xbox. Yeah. Xbox might never see it, but...
No, you're right. Who
made that? I don't remember who made
Wasn't it...
They're a whole new developer.
No. Oh. Okay, yeah. No, it was the same guys that made Killzone.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Huh, okay.
I'm gonna look
it up. Yeah, I know Hideo Kojima worked a little bit with it, too.
Well, Hideo found interest in their engine. Huh.
It was a good
Decima
engine.
Is what the engine is called. Let me go to the wiki here. Developers, Guerrilla Games.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Published by Sony.
Yeah, and
so
I thought it was really good.
Definitely
like,
not going to.
Yeah. I was surprised because I was making fun of it a lot. Like before, it was like a game just because I was like, oh, it's like Monster Hunter or something. But after playing it, man, I was glad that I waited as long as I did to have a game of the quality it came out as. And it is just kind of a one playthrough. Like you can go through it again, but I did feel it was like you finish it and you can pretty much just trade in the game. But at the end of the day. It was worth it. It was a long story. I never felt like I was like coming close to the end when I felt like I should have been. And all the characters were really like likable, which is really weird for a game because usually you get actors who have no idea what the fuck's going on. But I feel like they actually sat down and showed everyone the story and they got involved with their characters a bit.
Yeah, well, maybe they did, and I'm not sure if they did. Maybe they you know recorded the dialogue while the actors were doing motion capture for the characters. I think that ends up helping a lot.
Yeah.
Do you want to try? With the vocal performance,
I'm talking.
I think what's his name said that too. The what's his Elias, however you say his last name, Deus Ex guy.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I'm sorry. I'm lost on his name too.
I don't know how to say it. it's French Canadian, so it's like, Tufaux. I feel like that sounds too easy for it to be something like that. But that's what it looks like. It looks like Tufaux, which maybe that's right. I could ask him, I guess.
Well, this is not my round after coming out on top for a little while there.
Yeah, well, it's not my round either. I only have one kill.
Well, on mine, you've got four.
Oh, I was looking at some. I was looking at Kelchikin. Yeah,
that's me, sorry. Man. I'm not. I won like fucking four rounds in a row there. I can't fucking scrape out two kills.
I was then I was scared. I was like, oh god, did we find another bug? No, it's I think I played player three last match, which is why.
Yeah, we're kind of tossing our positions around. Oh.
Oh.
Oh, I'm just looking at the chat. Chat's talking up a little bit. Back to what we were talking about before. Scott says Counterpoint, Mass Effect 1, 2, and most of 3 are damn international treasures.
Just get Nicolas Cage. Why? Why did I jump into that? Like that was such a rookie move.
Geek variety.
There Scott goes with that lion again.
I'm not going to reiterate everything Geeks just wrote here, but he definitely disagrees with what Scott's statement is.
Yeah.
And Horizon, as far as Geek is concerned, is never going to leave PS4, just like Uncharted.
Yeah. Well, they also said they're putting Uncharted on Windows.
They are, right?
Yeah.
I hope so.
I mean, it's years later.
How could they not, though? I mean, I understand.
Look at that.
Like, publishing
that's me
rights
again.
And stuff.
Shh,
but,
get out of here.
Like, when the game is that good and it's kind of exhausted everything on one platform, wouldn't it make sense to move it to the next?
It's so hard, though, when you have, like... But the thing is, PlayStation sunk so much into Horizon and, like, that game.
Yeah.
Look how long it took. It was announced to me 3 years ago. Like,
that's why they're publishing it.
3 years ago, yeah.
Yeah.
If they're publishing it, it'll never be on Xbox. They're not concerned about money. That's one of those games that they want exclusivity.
Yeah. PC,
but I could see it. I could see it showing up on PC. Yeah.
Yeah. PC's like superior between the two, just because.
Well, that's. I mean,
the potential though,
it's
the amount of hardware
crazier.
You can jack into that, and you know, allow people to toy with is just hard to ignore. Like, you want that game to run at its highest level of quality, right?
Yeah. Well, I mean, it's not even just that. I mean, that's a good point. And the other thing to think about is a lot of countries don't have a lot of consoles in them, right? So they play games on PCs. You know, Russia, China, you know, the two other biggest markets besides the US, basically, play more games on PC. And I don't remember when they released it. It was the end of last year, or maybe early January. The Entertainment Software Association released their general sales figures, and it was, you know, like 6 or 7 billion for consoles. Like, oh, that's a lot of money, right? And then you see the PCs, PC game sales, and it was like 34 billion in a year. Mm-hmm. Like, that's how much bigger it is. Which is crazy to think about. I had no idea that it was that much bigger. I thought it was maybe twice the size. Not that bigger. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So Sony might want a piece of that pie. Mm-hmm. Yeah, PC Master Race, that's right.
I think the thing I'm still most excited for is going to be Death Stranding.
I don't think
Hideo's going to let us down on this one.
There hasn't really been any other game that's really like, affected me in the same way, too. Like, I guess Yooka-Laylee comes to a close second.
But that's
a very long, big
spectrum.
You know, it's a huge stretch between the two, of course.
I don't even know what Death Stranding is about. I've just seen naked dude from Walking Dead, and Guillermo del Toro is a weird CG character in it, and a baby, and that's all I know about it. Have they actually said what it's about?
We know we're some sort of. He said we're some sort of space traveler, and okay, so like the concept behind it was, you know, like how we like it took a stick and we turned it into a weapon, and that's how life kind of evolved for humans in a way. He imagines that, like, the concept is, like, imagine that instead of, like, it being sticks that we picked up first, it was kind of like a rope. Like, everything was slightly changed, and it's supposed to be a little bit more action than it is just straight horror, which I'm kind of excited for. But mostly, just, I think his story writing is phenomenal. Like, it'll probably make me question my existence.
According to the wiki here, it's described as an open-world action video game. It'll have single-player and multiplayer elements to it. It's being made in the same engine as Horizon. You already knew that. They're being very hush hush on the story.
Yeah, Hideo likes
very
to be hush hush about everything.
It looks, I mean, for what we've seen of the visuals, it looks really cool.
Yeah.
They said that was all in game rendering, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, the one thing I do know that's kind of neat, and this is just more of Hideo giving it his magic touch, if you play the trailers beside each other, the baby will appear in trailer 2 at the exact same time it disappears in trailer 1.
Creepy.
So it's kind of cool in that respect. They're like, yeah, I guess we don't really have much else to go on, but I don't know. Hideo makes
you die?
Wonderful games.
The pits.
No, not you.
Yeah, the pits. He fell in the pit.
I fell in the pit too, yeah. Yeah, I don't know, I wasn't a big... You guys are going to hate me when I say this, but I wasn't a big Metal Gear fan.
I wasn't a big Metal Gear fan either, no.
Take Robin would...
I don't want to say it. I'm like, oh, you know, I tried... I shouldn't say that. I liked the first two.
Yeah. Things got a little funny after that. Metal Gear 4 is a little too much.
Yeah, I mean, was it 4 that was all, like, Tom Clancy paranoid fever dream rambling?
Was that the fourth one? Old.
I really wish Robin was here. I think so.
Yes,
I really
yes.
think so. Because
the one where he was
really
old.
Old guy.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I mean, I watched my... I didn't play much of it myself. I watched my roommate at the time play it. And he was a huge Metal Gear fan. And I was like, I can't. How do you get into this? It's a 45-minute cutscene. I'm just like, oh, I just want to play the game. Do you guys want to try a new match?
Yeah, let's try a new match.
Okay.
I just crushed you guys like 4 rounds in a row.
What's a game haven't played yet?
Well, we haven't done Capture the Flag yet.
Oh my god, don't even remind them. Why?
God, no!
I think if you just set it to random, it would just change that type when you rematch.
No, I think
right?
it just randomly picks the first one, doesn't it?
I don't know.
It'll it randomly picks a gameplay mode.
But when you rematch, do you just rematch that one type, or does it switch it up?
No, it just rematches that one type. Although that's a very good idea.
Gotcha.
Just the random.
I'm gonna write that down too. Actually, to think about adding in.
Woo! I help.
Get a little, just a little booklet of stuff.
Yeah, we like our random stuff, man.
Are people chatting away still?
I
know Wade was watching and stuff, so give a shout out to Wade.
Oh yeah,
I don't know if
Wade.
He's still watching, but
Geek Variety keeps popping in.
Ooh, well, hello.
People in their online names don't get any of this.
Come on, let's get personal. First name basis.
No open matches? Are you connecting to make it? What's going on here?
It says connecting to the server.
We're connecting.
Uh-oh. Well, no, he's just here. His game isn't...
You're still with us, Nick, right?
Yeah,
Okay.
I'm still here.
For a moment, I thought the internet cut out.
Yeah, it just shits out entirely. Okay. No open matches. You're still connecting. Maybe
I don't think
you...
we can back from this moment. We have to sit here.
Uh-oh.
I hit all the... Hit all the buttons.
No, you did right. We're just
you're doing fine.
Acting.
I can't.
What happens?
We're stuck on a connection screen.
Yeah, connecting to server.
But a nice color of red is showing.
Oh yeah,
it's funny too because I went past you and I'm in the waiting for you to choose the screen.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Oh bugger.
Huh? You might have to force quit. I'll look into that because it shouldn't hang on that screen.
Force quit.
If you're trying to create a match. Uh-oh. Like all that for?
Can we force quit?
I will leave that to you, Kevin.
I think we can force quit. There may be a blank screen for people for a moment there. Hold on.
I need that.
Does anybody want to put on that intermission song?
Nope. You're only allowed a certain amount. Don't do it. It's not worth it.
Excuse me, buddy.
If for some reason we make a penny, they might just take it. I can't have them taking that penny. We earned that penny.
Damn straight. I'll have to break my knees over it.
Ah. Alright, celebration.
Oh, Reba.
Ba-ba-ba-bang.
Uh-oh. It's all going...
Metal.
It seems to be fixing itself quickly. We're gonna have so much fun. Remember, there's only 3 people this time.
I haven't heard Nick in a while. He's still alive?
Nick!
Oh yeah, he is.
Yeah, I'm still here. Yeah.
We get separation anxiety.
Very much so.
What map did you have it on?
Oh, we didn't pick yet.
Go just ahead.
That one. Yeah, that yeah. looks like a good one.
Oh, yeah. Okay, we got our game
back
up.
Back in action.
Who gets in first? It's
the
me.
Southern Ruins.
So I'm blue this time. Let's not get all confused here.
I am yellow.
I'm going to be the sheriff. It's been working well for me.
I just see an angry version.
It's you. We're waiting
of,
on you, Lance.
Oh, my bad, my bad. I was just thinking he kind of reminded me of Big Hero 6. Just angry.
The Southern Ruins.
Ooh, all
right, so capture the flag game where hate and distrust is built.
I did that too.
Oh, of course. It's like it had to be this map.
Your favorite. Didn't you want the bullets not to pierce anything?
No, nope, this is good. Oh, he's good. He's good. He knows what's going on. I can't have any of this. Oh, he's got my flag. Lance, stop him! Oh, I killed myself. There we go. That's one.
Damn it.
Wasn't me.
Oh, wow! You played me like a fiddle, man. That was embarrassing.
Orange. Oh, blue still has orange? What is this nonsense? Get on
it's
out.
It's okay, let's flip the talk over to television. Do you keep up with your shows?
Yeah, Nick, what shows do you watch?
Yeah, what are you doing?
Oh, nice shot.
I am a... Wow, that was extra sexy.
I'm sorry, I do that.
No, it's very funny. What have I watched? I enjoyed Iron Fist. I don't care what anyone says.
I thought it was okay. Not like it wasn't phenomenal,
it.
But it's...
Oh,
yeah, you got both of us.
It?
No nice. Way.
Yeah.
I haven't watched it personally. I don't.
Stop
here. Much of an interest
Stop
in watching it for somebody who's not really familiar with Iron Fist, which is.
Oh
like
no!
Watch.
Way. Sorry, that was so close.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I knew the character a bit from the comic reprints, but he was,
oh,
was
no.
like a big fan or something of the character.
Oh,
it's good. I mean, it's slow. It's a slow show to start. Like the first five episodes or so are very slow, but I enjoyed it because it's slow because it's giving you backstory for like a dozen different characters. And so there was
yeah.
I couldn't think of really a better way to do it. So I can't criticize. I would have criticized it more if it didn't do any backstory. So that was good.
I went like as a, watching it and I was pleased.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
oh,
I
no.
like what's his name? I like Luke Cage better as a character, but I thought the
okay.
Iron Fist show was better than the Luke Cage show.
I really liked, and I really liked the Daredevil show. I just got played there. Wow. Yeah, I really liked the Daredevil show, but I was not really sold on it entirely.
Yeah, well, they did a lot of work to make it better in the second season.
Yeah.
It felt like to me. Because the Punisher was awesome.
Yeah.
He was, I mean...
Good character.
Yeah, yeah. Daredevil himself is kind of like, whatever, you're blind, you kick people. But the Punisher was just like, he was such a badass in it. It was good. Damaged, like, Vietnam vet era Punisher is my favorite Punisher, so I was sold immediately.
And
no, it didn't let me down. Didn't let me down. He was as broken a human being as I wanted him to be.
That's
great,
I guess.
And what else is good? What else is good?
Yeah.
I've been catching up on Man in the High Castle, which I hadn't really watched before. That's been fun.
Man
if you have
High Castle. Can't say I've heard
Amazon Prime. It's an Amazon Prime show. It's based on a Philip K. Dick book.
Oh, that
So I am. I'm a big Philip K. Dick fan, so I've been enjoying it. A little slow to start, but it gets into it. It's an alternate history show, so it's kind of a if the Nazis won World War II kind of thing.
Oh, okay.
And it's good,
alternate
and they're not
history.
Yeah, and they're not afraid to plaster swastikas fucking everywhere in the show. Like it's at a point where you're going like, all right, I get the point. You're all Nazis, you know.
We've covered that in history class once or twice.
Yeah.
It's on the banner. Like, if I go to the wiki page, that's what I see is a...
Yeah, yeah. Flag. They really
I
don't
want you to know that that spawn was
punches.
Bullshit for both of you.
What are you talking about? It was beautiful.
This sounds interesting.
No,
is
no,
it just
no.
one season?
Well, it's there's two seasons on now. I just finished the first season over the weekend. So I'm behind on it, and I really enjoy it. Again, it started a lot slow. There's some good actors in it.
Yeah, I've seen what they have in the cast, and I like a lot of these people.
Yeah, 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 it's
what
good.
The hell?
Yeah.
What's his name? Rupert Evans, I think, is that his name?
There's a
couple people in it who tend to play
Rupert
good guys
Evans
a lot.
Plays Frank.
Right.
Frank.
Right, he's from Hellboy. If you remember the guy from Hellboy, the first Hellboy.
Oh, okay.
The, like, detective guy. He's great in it. And the guy that plays the main Nazi bad guy, whose name I can't remember, but I think is also Rupert, his first name?
Is it John Smith, the character you're talking about?
John Smith, yes.
No.
Yeah, he's the Nazi
okay,
guy.
Rufus Sewell.
Oh, Rufus,
name.
Not Rupert, yeah, and he's the guy
yeah.
from Dark City.
Okay.
Right, the good guy.
I recognize
the good
him
guy
from Night's Tale, and
okay.
I know that's like pushing it
oh,
back
yeah, that's
far,
it.
That far
it.
Away, but...
Yeah, yeah. No, I think we might be in the same age range. if you can remember that movie, yeah.
Yeah.
He played a great Nazi.
Yes.
In addition to playing in Night's Tale and Dark City. Well, my frame of reference for him is Dark City, I think, where he's very much a good guy. It's a draw. Nobody won.
So we all won one.
Unreal.
Yeah, that's exactly
unreal.
Right. We all won one round.
Twice.
So do you want to do a rematch, or do you want to try a different stage, different game mode? What do you guys feel?
Let's go a different stage, different game
change
mode.
It up a sure. little bit.
Capture the flag right. is frustrating.
Oh, yeah.
yeah, I'm getting the impression that you're not a fan of that.
My
one.
Favorite. Okay, so it all comes back to like when Halo 2 was really popular, and I used to like learn every glitch and everything to get that flag to my thing as fast as possible, and there were rules and stipulations, and it was really try hard, right? And we just. After I, like, committed so hard to that, when you play other games, the capture the flag, where it's kind of like you have to defend and attack, and it's in, like, this kind of a style, I just get frustrated because there's, like, it comes down to, like, who ends up where all the time. Like, that spawn behind
yeah.
me, I was, like, jumping, and both of you guys spawned right on me on either side. It was like, fuck. It's just no way. I'm getting
yeah.
out of this one.
Well, I had it at one point, and maybe I should make it an option. Because I like adding options, so maybe this would be a good way to do it. I had it at one point where you always respawn back at your base, because my frame of reference for capture the flag is like Unreal Tournament.
Yeah.
And on a real tournament, you always spawn back at your base.
Yeah.
But that made it kind of extra difficult for other players to get your flag, because you're invincible for that couple seconds
mm-hmm.
when you first respawn.
Is that when you get that circle around you?
Right, right. So until that circle turns red, you're invincible.
Gotcha. I think we might have to do a force down, by the way.
Mm.
We're having
we're stuck on that same screen
server
again.
Thing again.
Really?
Yeah.
Yes.
We suck.
Once
wow.
again, though, lovely shade of red.
I do like that font, and it's got a good drop shadow to it. It's
very,
very eye-catching.
Thank you. Thank
yes.
you. I thought the hard-edged drop shadow would work better than the soft-edged.
It
that
really
was an important
helps,
decision.
Really helps with the contrast of the colors. Really bounces
yeah,
off your screen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Apparently, I need to add a back-out button to that screen.
It would be helpful, certainly.
Because that's a little strange that it's locking up there. Because I haven't... Mm. We tested that pretty hard. Is your connection sometimes... a little finicky, like your internet connection?
No.
Or is it usually pretty solid? Okay.
It's been pretty solid here.
Okay. Then I need to fix that one in like the next couple days.
You're right, Nick. I should call my internet provider.
Their internet is trash. Don't listen to him. Whatever he said is bullshit.
Well, no, I'm asking because it's possible if it drops at a very specific time, like as it's trying to connect to the server, I could see how it could get stuck.
Yeah.
But either way, it means that I need to add a button to back out of that screen. I think is what it comes down to. Which is fine. It's like
yeah,
5 minutes of work, so I'll just add it.
Well, both
get a couple pages worth of stuff. You're like, this has all come up.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't
yeah. Well, the next update already has a bunch of updates and like optimizations and stuff, because I'm trying to get 60 frames a second on even uneven potatoes. So there's going to be some more changes coming soon. Yeah. Even when I'm working, even though I'm kind of thinking probably more about the next game at this point, there's still a bunch of stuff I want to add to Sombrero. Like, I have a list of things that I need to go down before I can say this is done.
Yeah, that's fair. And at least you're given the option to do that, right? Like, I think that's one of my favorite things about when you make games. It's just like, if something's not working or something's not the way you want it, you can fix it, but you can still call it an end game.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, I felt very comfortable with what I initially, and I'm just adding more to it.
Yeah.
Is what I feel like. You know, these little kind of bugs, even though it went through a lot of QA online play, but every once in a while, something like this will come up, you know, something that seemed like it had been fixed and has like this bug you're talking about getting stuck on that screen had come up months ago. And we all thought it was fixed. So I guess not. I guess I need to fix it again.
We are.
You went to the online one, right?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm in the game, so I'd hope so.
Yeah, Humphrey's connected.
Oh, I didn't go into the joint screen. That's my good. Bad.
So we're doing a Bandidos again. Eh? Well.
Well, we haven't done
yeah, that's,
that again.
We've that's on me. I kind of zoned out there.
Which one's the Bandidos one?
Idle.
Okay, yeah. Well, we've done that once, but it's good.
It's all good.
I'm not going to let you win this time.
You're going to just have to deal with it.
I feel like choosing the anime girl aside what looks like a marshmallow and a wedge of cheese is probably legit. This is probably exactly the fight we would have. These would be the same people.
I guarantee you. I guarantee you someone in Japan has that fetish. So it's fine.
I want a marshmallow, I want a wedge of cheese, and I want a girl. Let's make it happen.
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Oh, yeah, sniped. Oh, we all sniped each other. Wicked. Oh, I'm blue.
You got me, but I got you too. Oh, you're still counting up. It's not dropping the idol. Oh, there it goes. That was weird.
I wasn't dead yet.
I guess not. I thought I shot you, but I guess not. I guess not.
Oh, fuck yeah.
I feel like there's a couple characters that it seems the animation to die looks like almost they haven't died yet.
What I think what's happening is it's starting to play the death animation, and then the character starts falling, and it starts triggering the fall animation. So that's just that's a little animation glitch I need to look into. Apparently.
I'm never gonna make it. Why? Why did you spawn on that?
Oh no.
Nice, I got you with the last snipe.
So Nick, I'm curious, have you by chance looked into any options to getting this game to other platforms?
Yeah, I've been I went through the whole Xbox developer program stuff, and they have sent me now a bunch of dev kits, so.
So now it's just getting it on there?
So now it's just getting it on there. So over the next few months, I'll be putzing around with that while I'm fixing other bugs. And I picked up a Shield TV myself, just because I wanted one to play with. And those things are pretty beefy for Android set-top boxes, so I think I could probably get it running on there too.
Okay.
So I'm kind of doing that version just for the fun of it, just because I want to see if I can do it. Because it's really, you know, the hardware in it is very equivalent to what you would find in the Switch.
Okay.
So it would be a good first step in pushing it onto that kind of hardware, which, I mean, it's mobile, you know, it's mobile phone hardware.
Yeah.
However much Nintendo denies it, it's mobile phone hardware. So there's some things have to change. I'll just say that. I don't know that it'll be running in 1080p any more than Zelda than Zelda runs in 1080p on a Switch, which is not well from my understanding.
Oh, really?
I've heard some things.
See, that's the kind of stuff that Nintendo doesn't want people to hear.
Yeah. Well, it's weird, right? So I guess it's when it's docked, it runs at 1080, or not even 1080p, 900p. And when it's handheld, it runs. Well, it's a mobile phone. And when it's handheld, it runs at 720p. And at 720p, apparently, it's like super stable frame rate. But when you plug it into the dock to use it on your TV, there's a frame rate drop because it's running at a higher resolution. Hmm. They should have just left it at 720p. Like, there was no reason to do that. I mean, they wanted to show what they could do, but it kind of shows the cracks a little in the Switch.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. But it seems like it's easy, much easier to develop for than the Wii U. So I had a Wii U dev kit also, and I had it for a couple months, and it's like, and I just returned it because it was just a nightmare to deal with.
Yeah, well, that platform's dead now, so that was probably the best decision you made.
Yeah, I mean, and that's the platform I had in mind when I said I'm buying another Nintendo console for one. So I picked that up for. Actually, I guess two games. The Wind Waker HD. I never got to finish the Wind Waker on GameCube. And Bayonetta 2.
So as a rule, you don't buy a console for one game, but two, and you're sold?
That's it. No, that's the two games.
Well, it was also on sale on Amazon when I got. I think that probably helped. I think that's how I justified buying a second game, actually. I'll buy Wind Waker HD now because I saved $50 to buy the console, so I'll spend that $50 on another game.
Sure.
I really just bought it for Bayonetta 2. I'm completely serious when I say that. Because I really enjoyed the first one a lot. Yeah, I just the whole look and feel of it is just so over the top. I loved it.
Nice.
Yeah. What shows are you guys watching? Talking about that stuff.
Right now, we're getting back into Black Sails because it's fourth season. At least in this household, we're doing that. Black Sails and The Expanse.
Yeah, The Expanse is a good one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I forgot it. I just started watching that one, too. I've been enjoying it.
Yeah, man, it's really good.
It's good in the middle of, like, what I would want from a space kind of thing, you know? Like, I want a little bit of the normal stuff. I want some of the sci-fi. But I like how realistic it looks. Except for the very first episode, there's this one scene that really always haunts me, and it's that they walk down this hallway, and they go into an elevator. And they're having a real serious talk.
Yeah.
And they stop, they have their serious talk, the elevator closes, it waits a second, and then it opens again, and they walk down the same hallway backwards, and they have the camera in the different backwards, so you know they just literally walked into a room. And then walked out of the room. And I don't know what it was about that scene, but it just made me laugh really hard. It just was, like, so fake. It was just too funny.
But yeah, I mean, second season, they've pushed it further this time. Like, I don't want to spoil anything. But
yeah, don't spoil anything.
I can't. Yeah. There's so much that happens in this show. Oh, my God.
Yeah, well, I think they definitely upped the budget on the second season.
Oh, yeah, hugely. For sure.
Yeah.
And, like, just to get back to Black Sails for a bit there, I believe how the stats gone is they've doubled the budget for each season. And this is the big one that they're really trying to capitalize on. From what I hear, that's going to go into a new, quote-unquote, pirate adventure, according to the writers. But, are you familiar with that one, Nick?
I think I've seen previews for it. I've never seen the show.
Okay, well, it acts as sort of like a prequel to the story of Treasure Island. So it gives you the origins of Flint and Long John Silver and Billy Bones and all those guys. And the show ends on this fourth season. They only planned for the four, and this new pirate adventure that they're quoting, I believe, is referring to Treasure Island itself. Whether it's a film or not, I have no idea, but it's a very good series if you enjoy your drama and action.
No way you got away with that, Lance. I hit you with both of those.
Not a chance.
That's bullshit.
I guess, yeah. Samurai Jack. Rick and Morty's coming back now.
I haven't seen Samurai Jack yet. I've obviously seen Samurai Jack. I mean, I'd be lying to say I didn't watch the shit.
No, but the new stuff, right?
Yeah.
It's good so far, man.
It's good. It's dark. It's really dark.
Yeah, they don't fuck around with that new Adult Swim label that they got going for it. Like,
yeah, yeah,
it's a mature cartoon.
Yeah. I think I've already decided that I'm enjoying the original series.
Yeah, and I love how they kept with the art style. Like, they didn't bother to change it. Not like the bullshit they did with the Powerpuff Girls or any of that shit.
Oh, that was. I could rant for like 3 hours about how upset I was about Powerpuff Girls.
Please do.
And I shouldn't do that. I'm like a, you know, I'm almost 40 and I'm a dude, but I loved that show, the original series. It was smart. It was like a smart kid show.
Yeah.
With really good humor in it.
Yeah.
And the new series just did not have any of that.
No, they like turned it into more of like just like a, I don't know, you're more of like a Disney cartoon is the way I can describe
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it was just a preachy Disney cartoon.
Oh, really? I just saw how they looked and what, like, all it took was that one picture to turn me off of it. I'm just like, no.
Oh, yeah. Well, you can tell. So the original creator of Samurai Jack came back for his series, but none of the creators of the Powerpuff Girls came back to do the reboot. And maybe that's why. It shows. I feel like it shows a lot.
They put them in high school, or school now, too, didn't they? I guess that was
okay. Yeah, I mean, they had them in school sometimes on the cartoon. Yeah, but I mean, they were a handful of times they actually showed them in school. It wasn't a main part of the show. They're superheroes.
Yeah. Well, they would usually just blast through the ceiling or something, right?
Right, exactly. Yeah. Who wants to watch a show about like a bunch of girls in kindergarten or whatever they were, like first grade maybe? I don't want to watch that.
No, who does?
I want to watch a show about a bunch of girls in our first grade who are superheroes and fuck shit up.
Oh, man. I mean, it makes me scared for any potential remakes. Like, I really enjoyed Dexter's Lab, but I really feel that too could fall victim to the same problem.
Well, you should always be fearful of remakes, but yeah. Well, that was the same guy that did Powerpuff Girls, so I bet you if they do bring that back, he's not going to work on it, because he's doing Disney stuff now. He's not doing
Disney
Cartoon Network stuff
ones.
Anymore. What's that?
Disney took all the good ones.
Yeah, they kind of did. They took a lot of them.
Yeah. I haven't seen that new DuckTales cartoon. Has anyone checked it out yet?
No.
Oh, I have not. I forgot about that, actually.
It is out, right?
I didn't know it was out already.
I could be wrong about that. Don't quote me.
I don't know. You're right. I mean, the trailer came out long enough ago that it should be on, but...
You know
maybe
what?
I just haven't seen whatever channel it's on.
I'm a guy here with a smart device in my hand. I can just do DuckTales. Woo-hoo! And, see what comes up.
Lance, stop being the one that gets it.
God damn it, Lance.
What do you want from me?
What do you want from me?
Just, we're getting to that point now?
No.
Oh, scheduled to premiere in the summer.
Okay.
They All announced right. it back in February. End of the month, though, so.
As long as they get Uncle Scrooge's voice right, I'm happy.
No way.
He sounds like the Scottish rival.
I mean, he's still...
No way we're tied. No way we were Scottish, tied at point but... of a second. We are both at 0.83 of the 25. Unfucking real.
Baloney. Baloney.
I do like the new the look of it. I know some people were upset by the look of it, but I dig it. It looks like the old DuckTales comics, and I'm okay with that.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, it looks
I'm
like the old covers. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so
and they got the theme song and everybody's having a fun time with it. Everyone seems to be a fan of the series, those who are acting on it too, so
we'll find out.
Yeah.
I think there's one more thing.
It shows a lot of promise. Have you checked out Into the Badlands yet? Being a fan of Samurai Jack and stuff.
I might need to double check to make sure it's what I'm thinking of. Yes, I've watched episodes of it so far.
Let's do one more loot then.
I didn't get to watch. Okay, sure. I didn't really get a chance to watch much TV last year because I was basically spent a year on crunch time on the game.
Oh yeah, well, I totally.
So now I'm catching up. You know.
Yeah.
I remember seeing the trailers for it during like Walking Dead or whatever, and it's like, oh, I've watched this. Yeah, it's good. Good martial arts for a TV show, especially.
Well, and I kind of like that cheesy martial arts style, to be honest. Like, it's especially
I'm
when
okay
it's refined.
Yeah.
The one scene, he's like flipping over dudes, and he like cuts four dudes' necks open. You're like, that's good. That's good. That's some good martial arts right there.
Or like that opening fight scene where he does like some weird jerky shit to the guy's arm and just basically snaps the whole like assembly from the finger down to the elbow. Like, But they got that second season rolling, and I hear it's even better. Uh-huh. I mean, everything just seems to get better when it goes season two. But
that's not true at all.
No? You don't think so?
One of the most arguable things I've ever.
Okay, you're the first person to bring any negative feedback my way.
Well, I mean, just, like, older stuff, like, especially, like, the 90s shows that tried to, like, keep a season going, it was all downhill. I mean, we could barely get Buffy, and Buffy was okay.
Oh, is this what you're talking about? Is anything going on a continuation?
Yeah.
Okay. No, I thought we were talking about...
Okay, so the campfires are multipliers. Remember that this time. We're not going to get screwed.
Okay,
by
so this is with a whole new approach, because we've played this before and nobody understood the mechanics behind it, but Nick has so kindly explained it.
Oh, nice shot.
It's our own fault, though. We didn't read the instructions.
We didn't. We were bastards. Man, now I'm trying to get...
It's even available in 5 different languages.
Ooh, this game?
And you didn't read
can
any
you name
of them.
All 5?
Oh, yeah, no, if you go into options, you can change the language. Yes, it's English, French, German, Spanish, Italian.
Now, how many of those do you know?
English, and my Spanish is okay. It went through a translation house to do it. Oh, okay. I didn't like Google Translate it. I was tempted to, don't get me wrong, but their translation houses are much more reasonably priced than I thought they would be.
Yeah, you hear that? The people that make fucking Phantasy Star Online. God, damn.
That's an old grudge to hold.
Dude,
are you talking about like the Dreamcast Phantasy
Star?
No.
Well, yes, that is the one initially, but they have a Phantasy Star Online 2 now, and you can the best way to describe what this is it's like it's Japanese only, but somebody's like trying really hard to keep giving us subtitles, and you don't know what your items are ever, and I just wanted one server, just one English server.
Yeah, well, in their defense, I'm guessing that probably has a lot more text in dialogue form than Sombrero does.
Yeah.
That has none. and so that takes longer to translate, and it's probably a lot more expensive because there's thousands of lines of dialogue.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's they can afford it.
Yeah, right? it's a Sega game. Like.
Yeah, they can afford it. I agree with you. Maybe they don't think it would
release?
Have a big enough audience, but I don't think...
The game's been out for a long time.
No, but I'm just curious because the Dreamcast has a very funny timeline.
No. This is not the Dreamcast one. I want. No, I want the PC version to go.
My mistake.
Oh, baloney.
Yeah, because I forgot there was a PC version. I immediately think of the Dreamcast when someone says that.
Well, I can't believe you actually knew Phantasy Star. That's crazy.
That's what I default to. Well,
I played on
the Dreamcast
GameCube first, but.
The Dreamcast was the Dreamcast in terms of the games that were available for it was a better console to me than PlayStation 2. And I'm not someone who was a fanboy growing up. Like, I was a Nintendo kid. The first Sega console I got was a Dreamcast. And the games were just so good. And so different. Jet Set Radio was always a big favorite.
Didn't we play that?
Wasn't that
the first couch game we ever played? Was Jet Set Radio?
We don't have an episode for it, but yeah, we've definitely tried playing it a couple of times.
Yeah.
That's
such
a version out there, too.
Oddball game.
Oddball,
and stuff like
fun.
Fib Ribbon and Rez. Everyone thinks of Rez as a PS2 game. It's like, nah, man, that shit was Dreamcast first.
You know? Yeah. The Dreamcast,
and it looked...
Looks
better on the
Dreamcast. A lot of big franchises that are popular today.
Yeah. That ended up getting popular on other consoles, sadly.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, they ported a lot of their library over to GameCube, I believe. At least
I think you're right.
And, I mean, now we're starting to see them getting repurposed for PC, which is great, because I'm getting Jet Set Radio at, like, full HD.
It's
we did
nice.
Space Channel 5. We actually did it for the show.
Oh,
here.
Nice.
I don't know if everyone else agrees with that comment. I mean, we talked.
I like
it
Space
out.
Channel
we
5.
Quite, you know what? I enjoyed it for what
we,
it did
we,
to these
we
people.
We had a problem because we couldn't hear it.
Well, yeah,
oh,
there was no
okay.
music cues for
we were,
us while
we were trying to do the show
so.
With it, and we couldn't. At the time, we were not volumely sound to do that.
So what just kind of resulted was a video of just.
nothing but criticism towards the whole, like, dance move and all that stuff.
Because, yeah, you had to memorize the game off just
there's a lot of crazy shit that happens in that. And if you don't really understand, like, there's no context to it when you're hearing it go down, it's hilarious. It's perfect.
I can see that game being hard to play without sound, for sure.
Yeah, it was up there.
Yeah, yeah. But there are so many good games for the Dreamcast.
Yeah, man.
I still have mine. I still play it.
I have one here, too. It's just a shame that it didn't succeed. There's just so many good things for it.
Yeah. But piracy they canceled it too early.
Canceled it early. Piracy was almost the doom of it. Basically,
it was so easy to pirate Dreamcast games. Yeah.
And in its I never
did that.
Yeah. No.
Released. No, after they canceled it and it was not for sale anymore, then I started downloading games. But like when they were available for sale, I was like, no, man, I want this thing to be around for a while.
Totally,
I'll give him my money. Absolutely. But I could also afford to do that, you know? And I guess a lot of people can't, and they just want games anyway. So, I get it, you know?
Yeah, and I don't know, back in those days, there wasn't a lot of options for that sort of thing, so as soon as people found an opportunity to acquire what would be $60 or 80-some in retail price.
True.
For free.
Crazy Taxi, man, though. Crazy Taxi deserved my money.
Crazy Taxi. Gotta play that for the channel, man. I have that on PC as well.
It's still fun.
It really does.
The PC version's not great.
No. I do like the arcade cabinets, though. They come with the steering wheel.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. Those are nice.
You got another bottle in there? Or are we getting to the bottom?
This is it.
Yes, please.
So what are we doing here? Pop.
I don't know. What do you guys want to do? We've been going at it for over an hour at this point. So.
Yeah.
I say throw down the death match of death matches here.
Ooh, okay.
For keeps. This one will be for keeps.
All right. And then call it?
Yeah. Oh,
that's good.
Yeah.
It's 11:20 and I got to finish my
Where would you like to go for the map?
Let's let Nick pick it. What's your favorite map?
Clampett's Hideaway. That's the one with the ladders.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
That's my favorite. Have you guys figured out the ladder trick yet?
Just land on it and press up?
No, I don't know.
Damn it. No, it's a... I'll show you when we get in.
I am Zoidberg.
Zoidberg should press confirm.
I guess. Just kind of stared at him. I'm like, looks kind of cool. Clapton's Hideaway.
Oh.
Clapton's.
May you all lose this game.
Lance, that is your skeleton. I hope you understand that.
Oh, no.
It's your skeleton.
Oh, no. Yeah, it was. Right from the beginning.
Casualties. There are casualties.
Oh, nice shot.
Did I get you with that? Unreal.
So Lance being yellow,
Humphrey
being blue, and Nick being orange, who will come out on top?
The good-looking one, obviously.
The one with the hat?
The anime girl. Come on, I said the good-looking one!
Hey man, you don't know what people are into. Maybe they like squids.
Hey.
Maybe.
Hey. You know what? That's actually a fair point. I could be losing this argument already.
I would hate for that to be a fair point. There should never be a scenario where you can say, people are into squids, that's cool. That's not something that I ever want to...
Yeah, your game got really popular because there's this squid situation. That's, like, really sexually popular with everyone.
Oh, God.
Over-sexualized humanoid squid.
Yeah. What's the thing I keep seeing now? Should I put, like, a slime girl in it or something?
Ooh.
catch me outside.
I feel like I've been seeing that pop up more and more these last few months. And I'm like, I don't think I want to know what that is, but I'm pretty sure I know what that is.
I can take an educated guess. That's what I can do.
Yeah.
Oh, nice shot.
I know what these people are like. This is exactly what I think it is. Yeah. And of course it is. And because there's the internet, what is it? Rule 34? Yep, of course. Damn, you guys are a bunch of... You internet people are a bunch of weirdos.
All of
you internet people. All of you.
Every last one.
Including the history on all of our browsers.
Oh, jeez. You don't immediately delete yours when your browser closes?
I just accept that it's over for me.
It's time for you to be doing this, Chad.
Oh, Lance has a...
I've got a fluffy friend.
Come here, lunchbox.
Stop ganging up on me, yo.
You need to die.
I don't need to die. I need to
win. Oh, don't you knock that.
Cat, this is like the worst time. Okay.
I think Kitty thinks it's the best time.
The best time is Kitty time.
Did I get you with that bullet? Was that mine? No,
yep.
No.
Somebody got me.
Nick picked you off the extra kill.
Nick, do you have any pets?
I have cats.
Yeah, because they don't give a shit what you do, but they love
That's
you
right.
unconditionally. It's not like a dog that needs your help all the time. Don't get me wrong, I love dogs, and I want a dog, but I want a house before I have a dog, and not having a big house before having a dog would suck.
I'm with you there, especially in a New York apartment. Yep. I would feel bad, and I refuse to get a small dog.
Yeah, because small dogs are small dogs.
The rats.
This is not dogs we were talking about. Did I win?
Yeah, it works for some people.
That's it! I'm a winner! Woo!
Maloney.
Oh, let's pop that up.
Oh, damn.
That's a completed match,
yeah.
Right? Yeah. Damn.
Free with the victory.
With the two rounds.
I really excelled in that death match scenario, though. I took advantage of you guys.
All right, well.
All right. Well, thanks, guys. That was fun.
Yeah, man. It's been a riot.
Yeah,
thanks
for having
us. Had a wonderful time talking with you for almost an hour and a half. Minus the whole setup time.
Oh, it's all good. It was a lot of fun.
It's a good game.
Yeah,
what was it? I think I purchased it. It was like $450 Canadian. Sombrero. It's a good game. We can all play online. Just let me know, and we can do that.
It's on Steam today.
It's on Steam today.
Yeah.
And more updates soon, including the fixes for the bugs we just found.
Yeah, we found some bugs. We're fixing it. We're working together.
Yeah.
Nick, you got anything?
They're small though. The bugs are tiny. What's that?
You got anything you want to plug?
Yeah, people should go buy Sombrero. It's $3.99 US. It's the cost of it's cheaper than a Happy Meal at McDonald's. There you go.
And,
you're not even getting that like shitty plastic toy with a Happy Meal.
No, you're getting a good one.
You're getting the whole thing.
Like you're getting
like
right.
the
the Transformers
actual...
or the Clipper things, you know.
Yeah,
the fry grabbers. Yeah, you got some good shit in there.
And where can people go
there
if they want to follow you?
Follow me on like the social medias.
Yeah, the media.
They can go to Pixel Metal on Twitter or Facebook, and I'm on Discord also as Pixel Metal.
Ooh,
and people are welcome to add me to Discord if they'd like to do that.
Yeah, man. Cat, get away from the mic. You're gonna rub right up against.
The best way for carrier pigeon.
Yeah, if we're going carrier pigeon, what do I got to do to get a hold of you?
Mm-hmm.
Travel back in time because carrier pigeons are extinct.
Hey,
aren't
I
they?
Bet you
yet.
If I release a billion pigeons, all with the same message, one of them's getting to you. All right.
Or maybe it's messenger pigeons that are extinct.
Maybe.
Those aren't the same
I don't know,
thing,
there'd be
right?
no reason for them not to exist.
I'm
honestly
not sure.
I'm serious. I think they were used a lot. I think the reason is funny too. The reason that they were either near extinct or are extinct is because they were used a lot during World War I to send messages. Mm. So they all got blowed up, and that's why they're extinct.
And
I think that's hilarious.
Weirdly, I like wouldn't doubt that something like that would go through your mind, especially like think about it. You'd want to take out a bird because what if?
Right.
what if it's got a message that might ruin it? Right.
No, that's exactly right. That's what I think happened.
That's why Warzone's tore up the area. No, the area was all torn up and stuff because nothing would go through that area. Like nothing, absolutely nothing.
No.
But
nothing.
Anyways, fuck it. This is a game. Sombrero.
Yeah,
we got real deep for a second there.
Nick, so kindly gracious to us with his presence, and it was awesome playing with you, sir. For those of you who may have stumbled on this link, thanks to Nick's sharing of our links. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. Your support is appreciated.
Excellent.
Yeah, you guys should, if you came here through me, follow these people. They're cool.
Thanks.
Do that. They seem all right, you know.